Hello guys, and welcome to another MK Mobile character review, today featuring Pyromancer Tanya. As usual guys, please note the date when this video has been recorded because a lot of things may have changed since then, and if you're not familiar with the matrix I'm using in order to evaluate characters, you can find it on the top right corner of the screen. So without any further ado, let us put Pyromancer Tanya to the test. Pyromancer Tanya, guys, was released on the 22nd of January 2022, and as you can suppose, she isn't really available for souls up until now. She was never part of the old market, so yeah, she can only be obtained now for money, and probably in the future she's going to get a pack for souls, which isn't available as of today. Anyways, let's jump into details. Her attack is 45,360, which is the 6th highest among the gold characters and the 29th highest overall. The hit points, they are 99,840, the 14th highest in the game and the 2nd highest among the gold cards. The toughness is 37,800, the 31st highest in the game and the 10th highest in the gold league. And the recovery is 41,580, which is the 27th highest in the game and the 5th highest among all gold characters. The power generation is 110%, which is pretty decent for a gold card. So at the end of the day, Pyromancer Tanya is going to get the solid 19.1 out of 28 possible points. Pyromancer Tanya is all about fire, guys, and her special one doesn't disappoint. It is called Cannon Drill, and here it is what you need to know about it. First thing first, this ability can be completely blocked by the enemy. It has fire as debuff, which is awesome. It can be cast from distance, from mid-range, it's perfectly fine. It is lethal, it consists of 2 mini-hits, and it has the single tap rectangle as mini-game. And of course, when it comes to her special one working after combo enders, sometimes the enemy will block it, sometimes it will go through. Even in certain situations, it will be wiser just to make sure that you cancel the combo ender and then you do special one, even though it doesn't really make sense because after all, Tanya applies fire on combo enders, so it's a little bit messy, but all you need to know is that this special attack doesn't always connect after combo enders. So let's go to the damage section of this review. The damage of the ability is, the minimum damage actually, is 19,908, which is the 44th highest in the game and the 11th highest in the gold league. The maximum damage is 39,817, the 38th highest in Mortal Kombat Mobile and the 10th highest among the gold characters. Once again, the special attack can be completely blocked by the enemy. It has fire as debuff, it can be cast from distance, it is lethal, it consists of 2 mini hits, and it has a single tap rectangle as mini game. So for her special one, Pyromancer Tanya is going to get the solid 9.6 out of 13 possible points. Alright guys, it is time to talk about a special 2 of Tanya, which is called Surging Blast. This is what you need to know about it. First thing first, this special attack again can be completely blocked by the opponent. It has its own unique basically buff, which is called Devil's Dust. Yes, that's it. The interesting part about Devil's Dust is that it increases the fire damage that you take while it is active, but most importantly, you are also blinded, so that's pretty useful. In addition, the special attack can be cast from distance, it is lethal, it consists of 2 mini hits, and basically it has the multi-tap circle as mini game. With that said, the minimum damage of the ability, guys, is 49,771, which is the 45th highest in the game and the 12th highest in the gold league. And the maximum damage is 99,542, the 38th highest in MK Mobile and the 6th highest among the gold characters. Once again, the special attack can be completely blocked by the enemy. It has Devil's Dust as debuff. It can be cast from distance, it is lethal, it consists of 2 mini hits, and it has the multi-tap circle as mini game. So for the special 2, Pyromancer Tanya is going to get 12.8 out of 19 possible points. Up and over. This is the name of the X-ray of Pyromancer Tanya. What you need to know about it is that unfortunately you cannot cast it from distance, you need to be right next to the enemy. otherwise the ability will fail, which is weird because I tested that on the previous Tanyas that I reviewed and they had no issues with that, which probably means that it's some kind of a bug or something that has been introduced to the game recently, or she just, her x-ray doesn't like her combo ender. Nobody knows, it can be one of those. Anyways, so we already established that this ability cannot be cast from distance and it has mass cripple as the buff, which is quite awesome. When it comes to damage, the damage of the ability is 121,442, which is the 47th highest in the game and the 10th among the gold characters. Once again, the x-ray cannot be cast from distance and it has team cripple as the buff. So for her third special ability, Tanya is going to get 1.7 points, so that the total amount of points she gets for her special attacks goes up to 24.1 out of 36 possible. Alright, Pyromancer Tanya's basic attacks. A lot can be said here, but let's start with the fact that she has average punching speed, average basically recovery speed, average initiation speed. So when it comes to punching, she isn't that great, especially considering the fact that if she doesn't have any block breaker, she doesn't push basically enemies away after her combo. So definitely she kind of needs a block breaker if you want to use her as your main fighter. She can do decent without one if you time your basic attacks and your special attacks properly, but in the general case I would strongly recommend to use block breaking gear if you want to use Tanya as a fighter, which basically leads me to the main point. Even though she is not really a great puncher, where she excels at is the fact that she can set the enemies on fire after every combo ender, and that's an amazing feat. So definitely she will get some extra points only for that, despite the fact that she isn't a perfect fighter when it comes to punching speed. So at the end of the day, I decided to give her 8 out of 10 possible points for her basic attacks. Alright, as usual, I'm going to start this part of the review by reading the passive of Tanya, which is called Devil's Dust. Surging Blast, Special Attack 2, and a unique combo ender that has 30% chance to be performed, powder the opponent with Devil's Dust that sticks for 20 seconds. Characters affected by Devil's Dust are blinded and take 50% more damage from fire attacks and fire dots. Martial artists and outward teammates' combo enders become fire attacks and apply fire dot, stacking them for 2 times on an opponent affected by Devil's Dust. Now, without any doubt, this is one of the best supportive passives in the game, and probably the best supportive passive for a gold character. It is simply a game changer. You can use, for instance, Tanya in a team with MK11 Scorpion and completely annihilate your enemies, no matter who the enemies are, as long as they don't heal from fire. By simply using MK11 Scorpion Fusion Zero, you can stack up to 5 or 6 fires on the enemy and absolutely demolish them, especially if you have also Ravenous Melina in the team. And you can do that as well by using, for instance, Classic Rain. You just have to make sure that the character you're fighting is soaked, and you can then start spamming combo enders, applying fire to the entire enemy team. And when it comes to the Devil's Dust itself, do not forget that the enemy will be blinded. Not only that he'll be taking more damage from fire attacks and fire dots, but also he'll be blinded, so that's pretty cool. Once you have the Devil Dust, you can start doing Special One. Your Special One will do more damage, and then the fire dot will be doing more damage. So all we know, this Devil Dust things make sure that Tanya is an amazing fighter, thanks to the fact that she has fire on combo ender, thanks to the fact that once the enemy is set on fire, she's doing more damage with any further fire. Of course, if she does Special 2 in the first place, or the combo ender that basically applies Devil's Dust. And yeah, basically this is it. Incredibly powerful passive. So definitely she deserves 20 out of 20 points for her passive. She's a dual class character, so she gets 2 points for classes and 0 points for tagging attack. Alright guys, it is time to decide whether Pyromancer Tanya is a good character at the end of the day. It's not going to be difficult to answer this question, guys. In my opinion, Pyromancer Tanya is a pretty solid character. She has very good stats for a gold character, excellent special 1, excellent special 2, very useful passives, one of the best passives in the game, especially for gold characters. She's a dual class character, and her basic attacks, considering the fact that she applies fire on every combo ender, really, really good. The best thing about Pyromancer Tanya is the fact that she absolutely excels at Fusion Zero. You don't really have to worry about maxing her out. All you need to do is unlock her, and she's going to be one of the most valuable assets for your account, especially if you have MK11 Scorpion at any fusion, especially if you have Classic Rain at any fusion, especially if you have any good martial artist fighter, and there are many of those, such as, for instance, Classic Lucane. So definitely Pyromancer Tanya is one of the best gold characters in the game, and she definitely deserves my 3 out of 3 subjective points. And with them, she's going to score 76.2, tying with Lizard Baraka. On our current rankings, she is 31st, just above Nightmare Jason and just below Cold War Scorpion, once again tied with Lizard Baraka. So the final verdict for Pyromancer Tanya is going to be a great character. Alright guys, so it is time to see what you think about Pyromancer Tanya. 202 people voted for this particular review. If you want to be part of the next one, you're welcome to join our Discord server and vote there. I'm leaving link here and in the description of the video. So 202 people voted with the average score of 8.07. The most common grade was an 8, 61 of you chose an 8, and the least common was a 2. One person decided for some reason Pyromancer Tanya is a 2. Anyways, with this particular score, basically you agree that she is an amazing character, which is actually more than what was given by the Matrix. The Matrix just gave Tanya about 76 points, while you're giving her 80 points. So in a way, she's great according to the Matrix and amazing according to you. So if I have to choose between the two, it is really difficult because many of you noted the only drawback of Tanya. Basically, her passive's not really that useful against bosses, not at all. And that's it. Everywhere else, she is amazing. And one can argue that in survival mode, she might be a little bit unfortunate if you meet a lot of MK11 J teams, but it is what it is. You can just try not to do a lot of combo enders. With that said, everywhere else, once again, she's incredible, one of the best supports in the game, definitely deserving her place as one of the top tier gold characters. By the way, on the current standings, when it comes to your vote, she's 13th. She is just above Dark Fate Terminator and just below Circle of Shadow Kung Lao. So the final verdict for Tanya, according to you, is an amazing character. Alright guys, is Pyromancer Tanya a good opener? I would say, yeah, why not? I mean, her special one is pretty cool, it has very nice debuff, so you can definitely use her as a starter. Is she the perfect starter? No, but she can definitely do the job. When it comes to the characters that she counters, it's really difficult to say because more or less she counters every single character who doesn't really heal from fire, every single character that basically can be killed by dots, and this will probably mean that her worst nightmares will be characters such as Dark Raiden, characters such as, for instance, MK11 Jade, Classic Lucane, stuff like this. She wouldn't really like facing any of those characters. When it comes to the equipment, guys, it is really depending on whether you want to spam her special 1 or her special 2. You can try using Devastator on her. I mean, why not? After all, if you're spamming special 1, Devastator will definitely help you. But at the end of the day, it is totally up to you and up to the team that you're using Tanya with. If she's supporting, it doesn't really matter. If she's fighting, definitely she needs one piece for block breaking. It is up to you whether you can give her something to for instance, to boost chance for those special two, such as Rusty Chainsaw, or once again, if I mentioned, you can use the Devastator with any accessory that gives block breaking chance. It is totally up to you. And when it comes to the teams, the best teams for Treacherous Tanya, Pyromancer Tanya. So the best teams for her are the teams that she can support, the characters that can benefit greatly from fire, such as, for instance, Fire God Lucane, or the characters that can do a lot of fire without any issues, such as MK11 Scorpion, Classic Rain, basically, you name it. It is so easy to build very useful team, very great team around Pyromancer Tanya. All you need to do is just to keep her tagged out. She's going to be benched, and then the other guys will be doing all the work because, for one thing, they're great fighters, or, in the basically in the case of Fire God Lucane, he's just too good when he applies a lot of fire on the enemy team. Alright guys, so Pyromancer Tanya, what do you think of her? Do you like her? Do you dislike her? Please let me know down below in the comment section. Once again, she scored 76.2 and we labeled her as a great character. As usual guys, if you want to see more reviews, you can find the list on the top right corner of the screen. See you next time guys, take care.
Perfect.